We won't forget the Invitational Two Nations. They were the USA and Grenada, who finished their campaign yesterday, late into the evening, where Grenada recorded a fantastic win against the USA. Tournament pass holders, don't forget, you can access all games on demand for a total of 30 days. So, first up is the tie between Israel and Gibraltar. And there you can see some of the final preparations by Israel on the court. And I'm sure, like us in commentary, we're looking out for Naomi Komar. She's been the star entertainer of the Israeli side. She's the goal attack, and she'll be ready to get her team going back onto court shortly. Don't forget, you can have your say. You can contact us via social media and Twitter using the hashtag NEOpen16. We'd like to hear from you. Know which team you're supporting wherever you are in the world. Get in touch and we'll try and read out as many of those tweets as we can through the commentary on this day four, the final day of what has been a fantastic Netball Europe Open Championship. An invitational competition, Challenge Cup competition, and the championship. So there we see Gibraltar also in their final huddle before they're called out onto court. And I'm joined again by netball expert Maggie Jackson. Maggie, it's been a great 3 days. We're now on day four, and this is the first of the challenge games today. I'm sure you've seen an awful lot of these two nations, Gibraltar and Israel. What have they brought to this competition this year?
Immense. Israel, I mean, just to see their laughter, smiles, the dancing at the beginning, the dancing at the end. They're just enthusiastic. They're so thrilled to be here. They don't get here every year for Netball Europe because of the cost implication, but it's wonderful. Gibraltar, they are really wanting to improve and develop, and they are making themselves there every single time. So, yeah, Gibraltar very, I think, disappointed with their performance yesterday against Malta and the outcome. So they'll be really wanting to put out a better performance today.
Thank you. And they're the words of netball expert Maggie Jackson. So, Gibraltar, let's look at their squads. Goal shooter, Megan Martinez. Goal attack, Kelly Charoy. Wing attack, Janice Moreno. Centre, Joelle Moreno. Wing defence, Carla Gomez Neto. Goal defence, Kellyanne Samper. And goalkeeper, Linnea Okana. So that is the seven. You've just seen the squad names on the screen. And so over to Israel. They're all ready. They had the break yesterday in the competition. They're now back for their final game of Netball Europe and the Open Championships. They've had a gap of 3 years, and it's great to see goal shooter Talil Kupchik. She's taken to the court. There's the fans' number one. Goal attack, Naomi Komar. Wing attack, Tracy Powen. Centre, Shani Stosel. Wing defence, Mikhail Lieberman. Goal defence, Tal Segev. She's the captain of Israel. And goalkeeper, Shan Berman. There's the squad for you on the screen. That is the Israel squad that has competed throughout the challenge competition. And here we go. This is the first game of day four. This is the challenge match, Israel versus Gibraltar. Our umpires, as you can see on the lines there, James Thomas from England, and we have our invitational umpire, Chikatsa Lipoli. So Megan Martinez to secure the first goal for Gibraltar. So, Maggie, it will be a while since these two teams have come together at the Open level.
Yes, it is. As I say, Israel just don't come here as much. Gibraltar does. So this will be a great opportunity. We have this ranking and rating, and Israel need to be playing more matches in order to even get to the rating stages. Gibraltar are rated and are looking for those eight games that wanted to play to get some ranking points.
That was a great attacking play for Gibraltar. Joel Moreno safely delivered that ball. Good stronghold by Martinez at goal shooter. Just a held ball there called by James Thomas, the umpire. And again, good court craft by Moreno, Joel Moreno at centre. Moving the ball nicely, Maggie, around the circle edge, Gibraltar.
Yeah, they've got some very good, you know, good technical skills. They know that they're trying to triangles. It's just getting more competition. So when they get put under pressure, that they can still continue to play. But I think against Israel, you're going to be able to see Gibraltar relax just a little bit more because they won't have that same defensive pressures they experienced yesterday against Malta.
So the ball flowing really nicely for Gibraltar in these first few minutes of quarter one. And there we go. That's Kelly Charoy. She's been a good, solid performer for Gibraltar. For anybody who didn't catch the results yesterday, Malta did get the victory over Gibraltar. Quite a surprise to some people. They were expecting Gibraltar to come out the winners. So this will be a game that Gibraltar really want to perform well and just prove that their netball is going from strength to strength.
Lovely feed from the centre into the shooter, and yeah, well taken. Well taken by Kupchik for Israel.
Everyone's spoken, Maggie, about Nomi Komar, the goal attack. She's just full of life and loves this game, doesn't she?
She is. I mean, you watch her all the time, and you can't see her on the screen at the moment, but she's encouraging. She's really trying to drive everybody. Watching in the warm-ups, some great footwork skills she's got in that circle. Loves to do the ins and outs, and some great movement skills. But the passion the Israeli team bring, I think, to this competition, they just love being here. Remember them at World Youth Cup, and they just make everybody smile.
And there we see just Komar, the goal attack, just using the Israeli goal defence. Sejev, the captain. Oh, just disappointed there, just a loss of possession. Chance again for Gibraltar to extend their lead.
Very much a man-to-man game both teams are playing.
Yes, we watched Gibraltar yesterday, and Gibraltar-Malta, lots of one-on-one contests through the court. So guessing Gibraltar playing the same game and really trying to put a lot more pressure onto Israel in attack.
Israel creating a little bit, causing Gibraltar to make a little bit of confusion then, but just a little bit by their offline marking as well.
And there we see Gibraltar just extending the lead. Some good, strong quality movement by Gibraltar, keeping the width, using the breadth of the court just to try and split the defence in the shooting circle. But a contact against Sharoy, the goal attack for Gibraltar gives Israel a chance. Fast on their transition through the court. Not afraid to use the support on that transverse line. So can Nomi Komar and Kupchik, can they secure a third goal for Israel? Stossel, she's supporting well on the circle edge. Yes, third goal for Israel. That's Kupchik, the goal shooter, partnered well with Nomi Komar, the goal attack. And kept in there by Martinez. Just a few contact calls, Maggie, creeping in and around the Gibraltar attacking unit.
Yeah, so there's no need for it really. We talked about it a little bit yesterday, the need to just recognise they've got to keep moving their feet, come off the play a little bit. I think there's a bit of anxiety, different interpretations, you know, getting used to what the umpires are seeing. The umpires are seeing things correctly as well, but it's just getting used to the pressure in those first 15, because it's important for Gibraltar to come away with a good win today.
Just a miss there by Komar. She tried to keep that ball in play, but it is possession to Gibraltar. Good defence, Israel, but still in the hands of Sampere. Gibraltar quick to transition through to the goal third. So Martinez, she takes the score to 7-3. So we're watching Gibraltar on the attack, and just to give you some information, the most popular video through social media and Twitter was actually from this side, Gibraltar. And it was just a short video out there on Twitter. Gibraltar playing the fantastic quick passing netball. That was the most popular video on Twitter for this competition. So it's not always the championship squads, Maggie, that take the limelight on social media.
No, absolutely not. And I mean, Gibraltar have got tremendous support as well back at home, and there's a lot of them in the crowd here today. And, you know, I've just been watching just this last couple of minutes, although they didn't convert, some fantastic direction by Martinez, just guiding people around the circle edge. Just need to convert. But I have to say, Berman and Segev in that defensive circle for Israel are not making it easy for Gibraltar. And Berman particularly, some great footwork actually and some good marking. Very aware of what's happening.
Yes, just caught there on the cross-court ball, and that's just something that Israel just need to be careful of. That's a defender's dream, the lofted diagonal ball. So just important to readjust their play around the circle edge. But some quality defensive pressure by Israel, and they're out with possession again.
Yeah, both teams really need to be working their attacking play now just to get it consistent. A little bit sloppy in attack, but some good defensive play by both teams. It's just taking a long time to convert this last goal, Anita.
Oh, good long ball there from Joel Marino, the centre for Gibraltar.
Really, we just want Martinez just to put the shot up. She's been in good shooting positions. Just get that shot up.
Oh, great defensive work. That's Sejev, the Israeli captain at goal defence. It's just about taking care of this ball through the midcourt, and they're not able to retain possession. So Gibraltar again on the attack. A good swing. Swing of the ball across the circle. And as you say, Maggie, it's not easy in there for the two Gibraltar shooters.
No, I mean, the defence are working hard, and Gibraltar reluctant to put that shot up straight away. So it gives Israel another chance, another bite of the cherry. Gibraltar really like this right-hand side and swing it across. It would be good if we can just get repositioning around the top as well. So, because I think those Israeli defences, a bit more practice could be coming out for some of those balls which are swung across.
Just getting caught behind the defence, the Israeli attack. So they've really got to just think about pulling the defence away from the ball and just trying to lose them. A bit more movement off the ball would help them in attack. But again, she's doing well in there, isn't she?
She is. She's good. And, you know, I watched her against Cato the other day for Grenada, and she just never gave up. She was moving her feet round. She's definitely a leader. You've got Kumar at the top and you've got Berman at the back there. Two strong players.
So good pressure there. That's Kellyanne Sampere, the goal defence from Gibraltar, making it difficult for Coma, the goal attack. So Kupsik, just not enough on that, but she gets the rebound. So fourth goal for Israel.
So those kind of mistakes that really Gibraltar need to eliminate. They have enough experience and enough practice back at home. And I think Sarah Pays, the head coach, will be disappointed about a couple of these inconsistencies in the attack.
Well, that's a difficult ask of Kupchik to take those long passes in, particularly with the strength of Akana and Sampere, the defence for Gibraltar.
Well rebounded by Martinez there. Or Chavi, sorry. Beg your pardon, the goal attack.
So we're into the final 30 seconds. Can Komar get another goal on the board for Israel? She gets the penalty. Yes, she converts, so it is a scoreline. 10 goals to Gibraltar, 5 to Israel. And a chance again to get this ball up the court. Oh, well played.
Yeah, Lieberman's Gomez is having it's good play at wing defence, able to pick off quite a few of these balls that through that transition. As well as O'Connor. Both defence ends, I think, for Israel and Gibraltar, really, in this first quarter, have been top shot for them.
So, defensive pressure excellent from Israel and from Gibraltar. It is a scoreline, Gibraltar 10, Israel 5 at the end of this first quarter. This is the first challenge match of the final day at this Netball Europe Open event. We'll go courtside. Let's see if we can actually listen in to what's being said down there for the Gibraltar squad.
We're not coming off, we are still, we're a bit tight. one of you has to come off the circle sometimes, back the edge. One comes back, or she was free. All right, so that would be there rather than forcing it in. Janice.
The only one coming up on the top.
Yeah.
I've had to come up on the table. Yeah. She's very tired now, yeah?
You've got to come up, feed it up the court. These two shouldn't have to be coming down so much. So you two have to bring it. You two, at the edge of the circle, just be aware, just looking at each other, one back off, just in case.
Sha, I'm not passing it to you. Too long the tip, I'm passing it to the space. It's all
one that went across, really we should never play a diagonal across the circle, alright? So just think about the position and roll round.
Then what do I go?
Watch.
The
unforced. If you can't get there, then Kellyanne or Zania. Alright?
Stay there,
Zania, Zania's coming in for Kellyanne. Give you a break there.
Really good blocking. Good movement, you're playing nicely together. Alright, with the balance of the inside the circle, it's very good.
Right. You need to lift it more, alright? It's got to come from here, all the way up. Particularly as this is not 100%. So use the whole body to lift it up. The movement around the circle is fine, but that's where you've got to focus on lifting it, okay? Same with you, lifting it in, okay? That's the only bit that got a bit crowded there. Just come up. You've done a lot of good restricting and you've got a lot of ball back again.
I'm trying to restrict as much as possible, yeah. But then I'm having to come up to the middle nearly every time. And sometimes they come up and then someone else pops up, but they have to be there.
These two need to bring it up more. They need to bring it up more. But your restricting has caught at least two turnovers. So we've got the turnovers from that, so good. Carla, well done. All right. The only thing at the centre pass on one occasion, I think you face mark. Don't face mark.
Just send the ball to the time.
You did it once.
Might not be.
Yeah,
Kelly to get really blocking
in
the
action. Yeah, that's fine. It was one that I saw that
started off
right. That was
strong
right.
On the restricting,
and the rest I didn't notice, so it must have been right.
Or you can do it either way.
Face marking. I think she got to actually the line.
Yeah, and then it went. I think it was that. It might have been a set play. You didn't get into position right to get back behind her, so you close one. So, some words there to the goal attack from the head coach of Gibraltar. Enjoying the movement and just wanting a little bit more in terms of the accuracy. So let's see whether Gibraltar can extend this lead, or is it time for Israel just to get themselves back into the game, get a few more goals on the board. But so far, it's been a fine defensive display from Sejev and Berman, the Israeli defensive pair, and the Gibraltarians, the Samperi and O'Connor. So good opening goal there for the goal attack, Kelly Sharoy. So Israel on the attack. And we'll bring the changes to you for Israel as soon as we get them from the officials' bench.
Yeah, they pushed Berman, a goalkeeper, out to goal defence, and brought in Sachon at goalkeeper. So Berman having real impact in the first quarter. Now I can would understand that the coaching team wanting to bring her out. You've got Mayen coming in at wing defence. Sejev has moved from goal defence to centre. And you've got Sturman coming in at wing attack. And then for Gibraltar, you've got Reyes, just one switch for Gibraltar. Reyes coming in at goal defence. Some good defensive play by Gibraltar, just being able to turn that ball round. Score at the moment is 12-6.
So, good few substitutions, positional changes there for Israel. So just to confirm who we've got on court. Goalkeeper, Sachon. Goal defence, Berman. Wing defence, Mayen. Segev at centre. She's the captain. She's moved from goal defence. Sturman wing attack. Still retaining the shooting partnership. That's Komar at goal attack. And Kupsik at goal shooter. And as Maggie said, just the one change for Gibraltar. And that's Reyes replacing Sompere at goal defence. What do you make of the changes, Maggie, for Israel? Quite a turnaround in their seven.
Yes, I think Berman was having such a big impact. Maybe that's just bringing her out, letting her, perhaps helping bring it through the midcourt, because that's where they were struggling particularly. Just being able to get that through, because Israel really have had lots of possession but just cannot convert it into the attacking goal opportunities. Gibraltar, Reyes coming on. I thought the defensive pair of Gibraltar were doing actually pretty positively, but I don't know what's happening on the bench. We don't know. So that's definitely a coach decision there. Great rebound by Sachon there.
So Martinez just not able to convert there. Some quality attack. We've witnessed Gibraltar opening up their circle by swinging the ball across. But just not able to convert there. So Israel, Segev at centre. Can they safely deliver this ball through to their shooters? And here we see this is the penalty. Kupsik, she converts. That's seven goals for Israel. Gibraltar lead in this second quarter. So it's 14-7, the score so far. Both shooters just offering a little bit more movement there. Martinez, she was out of the circle. Sharoy was too. So just trying to split the defence. They sense the pressure, I think, Maggie, of this new defence pairing as well for Israel.
Yes, and both being very effective. And just what I thought, that Berman's actually having a big influence in getting that ball through the court. Just need to look at the angles that Kupchik is holding, because that's quite a difficult feed, and they're trying to feed it on a 50-50 ball at the moment, which makes it hard. But the defence of that Israel attack do create problems for Gibraltar getting the ball out the back line, so that's something that I'm sure the coaching team are looking at and trying to help Gibraltar work out what to do.
And the aerial ball there being put into Komar. She might be the smallest of players, but she's definitely creative in what she does and not afraid to take the high ball.
No, she's got great movement skills, great agility. And as you see, speed of confidence. We had to just turn, twist and pass out and then look for the pass back in. But a good, great rebound by the defence of Gibraltar. Let's see if they can actually now get it through the midcourt.
So keeping possession as well, just not forcing the ball, but they're
Yeah, there's just a little bit too many errors. They've got to realise that Israel have dropped off in defence and it can look all blue out there. And really, Gibraltar, as you said earlier on, have got to really take on the player, do the work off the ball to actually penetrate, making Israel make a decision.
So, missed shots for Gibraltar. Again, Israel back on the attack. Just couldn't keep hold of that one, so Martinez picks that one up.
Lovely feed through for Marino there, wasn't it? It's straight into Xavi, so that's good. Gibraltar scoring that well-deserved goal.
Again, excellent ball placement. That's from Joel Moreno, the centre for Gibraltar. Forced the error there. That's Janice Moreno at wing attack. Fast out to defend the centre pass of Israel. And Martinez. She gets the penalty. So 10 goal margin now for Gibraltar as we move into what will be the final 7 minutes of the second quarter.
Some super creative feeding just the last few minutes, isn't it? Just finding through an eye of a needle. Just some low bounce passes, giving a little bit more confidence to the shooters just to put the shots up.
And they did struggle, we talked about in the first quarter, the fact that the Israeli defence were getting to a lot of ball, often lifted ball, so perhaps that's just their tactical change to try and play the ball lower on the ground to outwit and get this ball into, particularly into Martinez on that strong hold.
Yeah, Israel defence by the shooter, goal attack, wing attack, really having a great impact. Something that's going to have to be sorted out at half-time, I think, by Gibraltar's coaching team.
Komar just couldn't convert that one. So on the attack again, Gibraltar. Some well-timed movement. Good passage of play through to goal there by Gibraltar. And Chiroy just couldn't convert. So desperate to get that ball down, Israel, that they tend to just put a little bit too much pace on some of the passes when the defender's really strong on the body as well of the attacker. But that's a great long ball through to Chiroy. She's just needs to regain that composure on the shot.
Yeah, you've got Gomez wing defence having a really big impact, giving the attack lots of opportunities. Shooters just need to breathe, settle. It's a big pressure, isn't it? You're playing in a big arena, playing in front of people. It's the fourth day of the competition.
And there we see Martinez, a deep breath. Just taking a little second longer there on the shot, and that was successful. Good challenge there by Berman, the goal defence for Israel. But gives the penalty away, and that's another goal for Gibraltar. Starting to extend their lead now. It's probably a big ask that Israel can get back from this, Maggie.
Yeah, I think so. What I want to see is that continue to work hard, which I'm sure they will do. But I'm looking for Gibraltar really to start putting together. They've shown little snippets of what they can do, and it's just getting that consistency and the flair, because they're just loving it as well. I mean, Gibraltar are out there swinging the ball around the court.
So So good play through the midcourt by Israel, but it is that ball into the goal third. They've really got to see some movement off the ball and not get their midquarters drawn too high on the court as well, exposing the likes of Komar and Kupchik. They were left on their own back there behind the defence.
You have to have a low centre of gravity out there. There's a lot of low balls being bounced in.
So Gibraltar able to extend their lead. And there we see two players hit the deck, but helping each other regain the footing. And the umpire just asking the ball girl just to wipe the floor there. Played in great spirit this game, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what it's all about. Part of the whole isn't it, to increase participation, increase performance. And you're wanting to see these young women playing out there and enjoying it, but winning. They're all performance players, so you're wanting them to achieve the whole time.
Just holding body between the ball there. That was O'Connor for Gibraltar, but just can't distribute that out, giving Israel another chance. So Sturman, she's in possession, swinging that ball across to Segev.
Just wanting that goal shooter, Kupchik, just to come across then at that point.
Komar just leading the way. Using Segev. And also looking and linking well there with Sturman.
Gibraltar definitely not having it their own way in this top third.
And that's a good hold by Cheroy. Good court craft there, waited for the ball to swing across, and she's holding strong, protects the space away from the defender. Good hold on the front of the defender as well, makes that much easier and easy, less stressful ball can come into her.
Great marking by Gibraltar defence there, really being ball side. Kumar, I think she has the ability to be able to get round in front, but asking for that over ball, which the feeders quite rightly weren't going to give her that time. Super attack, but great attack, but just couldn't control the feet.
Good strong arms, but possibly caught on the obstruction. Yes, that's the goal defence raise. So can Israel take advantage of that 2-on-1 in the circle? No, good work from Akana. She got in the mix there. We always say when it's 2-on-1, the ball should find a shooter, don't we?
Yeah, and you saw Kuma starting to try and mark her like you should do, so the ball could get over to Kupchik, but she just didn't. And all credit to Akana, actually, just kept her feet moving, which is what you want in defending to do. But totally agree, Israel should be able to get that ball in there in 2-on-1.
So 5 seconds on the countdown. Can Gibraltar get this last shot? No, they can't. And it's half time. Gibraltar 24, Israel 9. So a strong performance by Gibraltar, some excellent work and linkage through the court. She's been a strong starter for Gibraltar, Joelle Marino at centre. And we've been impressed with the defensive pressure of Israel and Gibraltar combined. But it is the quality attacking work of Gibraltar that has allowed them to move ahead. good feeding into the circle. There's still a little bit of tidying up to do, Maggie, in and around the attack of both lineups.
Yeah, I think definitely. I think Gibraltar will be looking at both ends. When they get the ball through into the top, you want to be asking Xavi and Marcus just to settle. But then from the back end, I think really trying to work hard on getting the Gibraltar defence, just bringing that ball out. They've got the capability, but they've got to step up against Israel and not stand back, because Israel are creating many errors for Gibraltar to make.
So there are comments. We'll go down courtside to Israel's bench to see if we can again listen in. And you can listen in too.
And guys, I want to see, I told you in the last quarter, but a fake pass to Nomi and see if they both come to Nomi. Like, and I mean big, I mean like bang, and then just don't give it. And see if they come on to Nomi. And then Phil will be there. Their centre passes, let's focus on the wing attack, because the goal attack, we don't mind if she gets it in the centre third. She's not so dangerous there. Mikhail, try to get around the outside of the wing attack on the centre passes, so then Tao will double mark her from the inside. And then you know Sean is going to essentially let her goal attack come out for the centre pass, and then you're goal side of her and you're just stopping her getting towards the circle after the centre pass. Don't try and intercept, don't follow, just stay and stop her coming in as much as you can, stopping her from coming in. If you can even stop her coming into the third, you know, if she's gone in for the centre pass.
Lara, push her up more. Under the jacket.
Guys, we still need a little bit more.
Under the jacket.
Coming towards the ball, clearing out. Coming towards the ball, clearing out. You're finding it quite hard to clear because she's kind of blocking you. And you're like turning to clear, but she's there. You almost have to put as much energy into clearing as you do for going for the ball. And so if you want to clear, you like roll off and she's there, maybe try and do a little dodge. Like, you can't go towards the ball if you're like this, she's there, and get round her. Guys, I want you to be disciplined with your lean, 100%, but when they step in onto one foot, or when they step back onto one foot, that's when I want you to really try.
Yes, don't let us step in.
I know, but do it anyway, because it's right. If they call you, they call you. But obviously you have to have 3 feet from the initial position. If you're even the tiniest bit too close from the initial position, then you are too close, right, if you stay there when they step in, because you were too close to begin with. So get more than a metre, and then, yeah, if you've seen them step in, that's when you really want to... Yeah, she does. So if the other one of you, it's not always you that has to mark the goal attack, because if Sean's like lost her and she's run into the circle and Sean's behind her and she's not there, you can mark the goal attack. You know, if she steps in, that's when you should really try. One time she actually stepped back, you were behind her. You could have put your hand up and marked her, but she stepped back towards you, and you only have to be a metre.
So you've just been picking up some of the information down there on the Israel bench. It is a big scoreline for Gibraltar. They take a massive lead into the second half of this, the challenge game and match. First up on day four. So the Gibraltarians, they'll be looking to press ahead with the lead. They want to finish this competition strong. Lots of supporters in the crowd from Gibraltar, willing their team on, wanting a strong, solid final performance. At times a little inconsistent, just sometimes forcing the ball into the shooting circle. And we've witnessed Berman and Sashan, the Israeli defensive pairing, putting out a great second quarter display. So some tidying up to do in attack for Israel and Gibraltar. We'll go down to see if we can pick up any information on the Gibraltar bench now.
I'm going to try that thing on the
Stand up. I'm you. You're wanting to go that way. So I keep you there, and then I turn and run. I turn and run.
She's coming this side off me.
Okay. Keisha mustn't come down too far either. Keisha, come on down, please.
Why are you standing? Sit yourself down.
No discipline here.
Honestly,
don't come down too far, all right? We're putting the pressure on our defence to bring it up. So you and Joelle should be getting it here or just over the line. That's the places one of you should be getting it. Joelle gets it here and you're cutting across to get it nearer the edge of the zone. And all Louise coming out. Okay. I want to try and get them this quarter to really bring it up. So we can work on that, yeah? Because that saves you not getting tired. Okay? How much time is it? 1 minute. Girls, have another drink. Have another drink. Drink. Drink and then come round. Right, 15 goals this quarter. I'm on. Six down.
Yeah,
watching.
Girls, they've had plenty of opportunities. Come on.
One, two, three.
So here we see the two teams making their way back onto court for this, the second half, game one, day four. And this will be the final appearance of Israel and Gibraltar in the challenge competition at Netball Europe Open of 2016. So we're just waiting for the umpires to restart this game. So, second half underway. This is quarter three.
Good defensive pressure by Gibraltar here, really forcing the ball to go wide, yes, and a great tip by the goal defence.
She always seems to find that loose ball. That's Nomi Komar, the goal attack for Israel, but it's tough in there. Some excellent defensive pressure being put on by Ray. Strong arms over the ball, and there we see again, just timed out, Komar with that intensity and limited options in front of her. And that's the result of Reyes and O'Connor, the defensive pair from Gibraltar. So you can see a change lineup for Gibraltar. We can see Kelly Chorry, she's dropped to goal shooter. And just some spectators in the crowd just saying to us, she's here at the Netball Europe Open, but next weekend she gets married. So she's and the crowd are just hoping there are no injuries. So we wish her well. And that's Kelly Chorry, the goal attack for Gibraltar. So a big celebration due, and it seems there are more bridesmaids on the court as well, three of them from the team. So Gibraltar, they'll be wanting to finish really strong. And here we go, Israel. And this is Sturman. Segev really trying to just open up the circle, wait for that opportunity to arise to offload this ball to a shooter. But just putting the ball, Maggie, into the space of the defence, really, you've got to really try and place that ball away from the defender, haven't you?
Yes, and it was a shame, really, because they actually they missed an opportunity to feed Kumar in within that little pattern of play then and force the ball over to Kuchik, which actually wasn't necessary. And that was a shame because they were working hard there. But, yeah, placement of the ball is essential. Just got to watch the defence. And Gibraltar defence, Reyes and Akana, yeah, are doing well. They're wanting the ball to be lifted and force the ball to be lifted.
So electing to play the low ball in. Oh, Komar just couldn't convert. Still possession with Israel. And she gets the penalty. So saved there by the penalty. Komar was desperately wanting one of the mid-quarters to be on the side of the throw-in. So not a lot of choices for her. Just need to look at their structure, Israel, around that circle edge. And again, Shuri, she's got the court craft. Good defence up against her, though, but she does come out with the ball and is successful.
Yeah, nice pass play by Israel. Good opportune goal there by Kuchik, so well done.
And again, nice feed. Fast flat ball from Joel Marino, the centre. Links incredibly well with Kelly Chorry. We've witnessed that through the whole of this competition. And a good hand again. It's turned into a bit of a defensive game, or that's where the ball, a lot of ball's being turned over, isn't it, Maggie?
Yes, it is. And I mean, it's good to see Chowry's just settled a little bit more, having changed to goal shooter. They're finding her a little bit more easily because she's wanting that front ball, she's holding the front ball, a bit like Kumar actually, playing a little bit similar, same court craft.
That's better by Kumar, just getting on the front of the defender.
Yeah, if you can get the feed right for the front defender, the defender will contact if they're coming round. You just want it to the gut, we call it, the gut pass.
Really looking to give the first time ball Gibraltar as they move through the court. Not afraid to put the ball back to the third line and reset. And that's nice play again. She's got the flair, Joel Marino, the centre, the vision to just volley the ball through. But not able to convert, gives Israel another chance.
Nice pattern of play there by Gibraltar there, really reading it and not forcing it in, but swinging it around to play the triangles.
So good attacking structure by Gibraltar, opening up the circle as we've seen throughout the whole of this game. Not afraid to move the ball around. There it goes again. And just by swinging that ball across the circle, it allows the shooter to be that great front option. And she goes again. That's Chowry to convert, enjoying the game so far.
Yeah,
Tomar just being restricted on a movement by the goalkeeper, O'Connor. So Tomar to take the front and using Sturman well. Just losing their accuracy. They're having to work really hard, Maggie, in the Israeli attack, aren't they?
Yeah, and it'd be good to look at the stats going forward because they've had lots of opportunities. And it just makes you realise, isn't it, how accurate when you watch shooters just putting the ball away all the time, how much practice they're putting in. And hopefully these guys then realise, actually, go back home, practice. You just can't avoid the practicing every day as a shooter. Get that consistency.
Again, just off balance there, Therese. So she used Moreno on the wing attack. So passage of play. This is an effective run by Israel. Let's see if they can just get this goal. Still wanting the overhead, but Kupchik, she just comes out forwards towards the ball side.
Somebody who needs to go to the top. Yeah. Just wanted one of the shooters just to go to the top, just to make the defence, make a decision, and then that would have opened it up, I think, for Kumar under the post. Israel really are giving them lots of opportunities. There's lots of turnovers, but then we throw it away.
Again, some good work by Sashan, the goalkeeper. The long ball hurled in by Marino. And again, Israel out with possession, so they've been successful in defence. It's just about getting that goal at the other end.
And it's what I call really clean defending as well. Both circle defenders really understand what it needs to actually get round the player and work it.
Cherry again converting for Gibraltar. She's in the goal shooter role. So Israel, let's see you work this ball through. Kupchik's out. Safe pass to Sturman. Got the contact, so Naomi Komar. Great rebound. Oh, second chance, but not able to convert it. As we move into the final 4 minutes of this third quarter.
That was balletic by the wing attack, wasn't it, for Gibraltar? Really stopped herself going offside. A little bit of flair and craft.
Some strong words of encouragement from Israel and the bench players, but again disrupted by the defence of Gibraltar. And a misunderstanding. Just starting to see a few tired legs out there, I think.
Yeah, the concentration's gone a little bit, and they just need to take stock as they go into this fourth quarter. And as the coach, I think we'll need to give some stern words, particularly to Gibraltar, and just turn, look. You still use the fast play, but you need to be looking at where the defenders are and what other options you've got. Again, some great. It's just that last ball just into the circle, letting them down.
So tried to play the ball back in there, Chari, but not able to. So let's see. Naomi Komar. Yes, she can convert. That's been a few minutes coming in this third quarter, but you can always rely on Komar. She'll keep fighting. She enjoys every goal, Maggie.
Yeah, and I've just been watching at the other end. The goal shooter goalkeeper having a good old chin wag at one point and about something that had happened to them in the circle.
Great understanding there. Cherry again.
Yeah, good leg work by Cherry as well there. Be able to take that ball strongly.
Moreno comes out with possession. Good swing, using the width of the court in the middle, Gibraltar. And some really nice feeds going into the circle. Great ball handling skills there from Moreno on the wing attack. It's just finishing off, Maggie, isn't it? Just starting to see a few errors creeping in and missed shots.
Yep, and this is where when you watch the higher performer players, you know that they've got to be concentrating for 60 minutes. You want them to close out a game. And I'm sure Sarah Pies will want Gibraltar to be closing out this game and going into this last quarter. So concentrate, put everything into it, don't leave anything.
And a good umpire advantage there, just allowing Gibraltar to move that ball through to goal. Cherry again, she's converting now. I'm sure Gibraltar will still be searching for a little bit more consistency, trying to reduce those unforced errors, some passing errors. Found the gap there. That was the work of Moreno. Right through the defensive line of Israel. So Berman and Sashan not able to intercept. And it's almost the end of this third quarter. Cherry gets that goal in the final seconds. So end of quarter three, Gibraltar 38, Israel 12. It's not always gone the way of the Gibraltarians. They've had to work incredibly hard. Some good solid defensive pressure through the court, but Sashan, the goalkeeper, Berman, the goal defence for Israel, they've disrupted the accuracy of the Gibraltar shooting pair. So one quarter left, it's the scoreline 38 to Israel's 12. We'll go down courtside and listen in to Gibraltar.
Emily, how many are we down? How many do we miss? We miss seven, all right? So we're still missing too many. Yep, we need to know them. Right, we are still forcing the circle, and you are forcing the circle. You have stopped. You've got to stop forcing the circle. I'm going to be really harsh on you, and you have got to stop forcing it. All right. So we need to play it round and move it round. We've had three or four off the back. We need to keep possession, and we need to score, because that means we've lost it. We've lost the opportunity of a shot. So you need to do that. In terms of bringing it up the court, I thought we was better. I don't think you had to come down so far as many times. You still had to come down, so we still need to support bringing it up more. Yeah. Circle was okay. What you have to be careful of at this end.
She's getting pressure.
Is this goalkeeper, this umpire, calls up for anything hands out here? Hands have to be in, because he really pulls it up, all right? Okay, you've done all the changes?
Yeah.
We can't afford it.
She's told me before. Yeah, but I'm making a point, because I have said so many times the whole tournament about not forcing a circle. So, and you told me the last time you had got it, so I'm just putting the pressure on you to cope with it. That's why. Okay. Emma, you sure? Absolutely sure. Okay. Yeah, okay. No, she came to say she didn't want to play. No, okay. So you play for her. Okay?
Let's go long.
That means when you get the ball, focus, take a breath, shoot. Take a breath, shoot. So slow it down, you're a bit more tired, we put you back there. So you do, you know, keep there and you put more time to go.
When I'm there.
Less time. Okay? So go do that. Okay? Very well played. But it's tournament games as well, it's hard work. But the pace is fine. You did very well. Some good interceptions. That quarter there was better movement up the court. This is good. Okay?
I think that's for me, that's like my personal thing to work on.
Let's go. Everybody together.
So some words there from the Gibraltar coach. As we thought, just asking for a little bit more consistency. Few too many missed shots, but equally lots of positives for Gibraltar to take into this final quarter. And just tidying up there, the Gibraltar head coach, just asking for players just to be careful of the number of obstruction contact calls and being aware of obviously what the umpires are picking up on. And that's all about tidying up and keeping yourself in the game. Unforced errors, often the coach's nightmare. So I'm sure Gibraltar will be looking just to rectify some of their play in quarter three. And here we go, final quarter of this challenge game on day four. So an awful lot of you out there sending your comments through to Netball Europe and also using the hashtag NEOpen16. We're keen to hear from you, and it's been great contact with an awful lot of netball fans out there across Europe and around the world. So with the hashtag NEOpen16 so far in this competition, over 350,000 people have been reached using the hashtag. That's sending a powerful message out there about netball, about its popularity. And as we said earlier, the most popular video on Twitter so far is from the Gibraltarians who are on court in this final quarter of match one. And that was all about their fantastic quick passing through the court. So if you've not seen it, just go through to hashtag NEOpen16, take a look at the short clips, the videos, and you'll be able to see the most popular one there. That's Gibraltar playing their fantastic quick passing through court. And the total views, almost 41,000 total viewings of the videos that have been going out to you through the Netball Europe Open Twitter handle and through the hashtag NEOpen16. And Jennifer Purcell, you're out there so excited, she says, to watch today's matches. Hashtag this girl can and netball family. And the comment from Nicola McCleary. I'm making the connection to Scotland there. And McCleary, their wing attack, final game of our Netball Europe campaign, must win game for Scotland today. Everybody loves game day. Gail Parata, the Scotland head coach. She's looking forward to the clash that's coming up against Northern Ireland next up at 11. She's giving a big shout out to the Thistle Army. Loud and proud again, she says. Back again today, please. Hashtag backing purple. So keep your messages coming in. Who are you supporting on this final day of the Netball Europe Open event of 2016? We'd like to hear from you. Send us all of your comments and we'll do our best to read them out over the commentary of today. Just forcing the ball there, Israel Maggie, and tight defence again in this final quarter by the Gibraltar pair.
Yes, Ampere and O'Connor are doing a really good job and forcing it. And just need to get Kupchik off the baseline, really, in order to just give them a little bit more space to be able to feed that ball. But still, Israel interrupt Gibraltar's attacking play and is back with the ball with Israel again. Not for long.
So lots of changes in play, and it is a result of the defensive work at both ends for both countries. But that's the solid connection of Joelle Marino linking with Chari, the shooter for Gibraltar. And we see Rodriguez linking with Cherry well.
Yeah, much better start for Gibraltar in this quarter. Being able to find Cherry particularly and get the ball down. Now we can see that fast play that's been mentioned, you said, regarding the video. Gibraltar really have taken, beginning now to become a little bit more consistent and have those opportunities. Now, come on, Cherry, let's get the ball in the ring.
Yeah, just listen to you, Maggie, and Gibraltar, they've got a fantastic lead now. 45 to Israel's 12. Certainly, we won't lose any sight of the spirit, determination and real passion for this game of the girls out there in blue. And that's Israel. They'll keep working through to the final whistle. But it's proving tough out there with some quality defensive pressure in these first few minutes of the final quarter from Gibraltar. But really do enjoy their ability to swing that ball around the circle edge and find the front position, particularly the work of Cherry, the goal shooter for Gibraltar. And we'd probably just want to try to see or try and encourage Sturman, the wing attack for Israel, just to not necessarily offer for the ball off the circle edge, but actually reverse that so we see, Maggie, that attacking movement to get on the circle edge to feed the ball to the shooters.
Yeah, very, really important. And just keep moving on and off, getting the centre wing attack. Sturman and Segev just working together a little bit more. But this is the kind of competition that Israel now will go back. They know they've played. They'll look at the live streaming videos and they'll just know what they've got to do to practice and improve. And that's the only way. You've got to experience it to know what to do against these types of opposition.
Yeah, it's just a reliance there on that long ball from Berman. But good intercept. That's Segev. She's the captain. She's worked tirelessly through this game. And Komar just desperately trying to get this ball close to the post. It's so hard when you rely on the overheads and you run out of court. So little bit more movement needed in the Israeli shooting circle.
Yeah, I think that's the thing they'll take back to Israel and work on. Great, great attacking play. That was textbook for Gibraltar, so well done. Just going to set the shot, bend those knees and push.
Rebound there goes to Chari. She'll convert. Just a bit of encouragement from her to Rodriguez. Sometimes the hardest shots are the ones that are directly under the post. So Kupchik, she's out. Komar is in. And that was better. Just a one-on-one in the circle. Komar holds strong, but just she'll be disappointed with that. Not able to convert.
It's a good matchup between O'Connor at the back there with Kumar, I think. You know, some strong rebounding. O'Connor's going to have to, you know, has had to really pull that ball in because Kumar's ready for take anything in the air. Well done, Berman, directing traffic as you bring that ball through. She's had a good game. I think she's really tried hard, along with Segev, to have that leadership, hasn't she, through the court?
Yeah, some good work through the court. Just often that final ball in, the attacking third for Israel. And if you witness the last passage of play, Sturman just got the ball too much on that, just a misunderstanding on that final ball to the shooters. But lots to learn, lots to take home for both of these sides, but in particular Israel. They've not been around in the European event for 3 years, so it's great to see them back, and they will be no doubt reviewing their performances, looking at how they can take their game forwards. But it's proving a massive wall of defence down there for Israel, not able to get this ball through. The slick passing of Gibraltar. It's been witnessed by several individuals, particularly from those short videos on Twitter, but we've been able to witness that today. It is just about finishing off though and trying to keep that composure on the shot. So Komar, she gets the rebound. And there we go, that's a goal on the board for Israel. As we move into the final minutes of this, the challenge game, the first game up on day four.
Yeah, Judy Aknin from Israel is on the Netball Europe board, so very active. And Israel are a very, very active member of Netball Europe. And part of Netball Europe's purpose is to really increase the play of netball throughout Europe and beyond. And yeah, we thank Judy Aknin. She does a lot of work with the website. And so it creates that extra link, I think, with Israel, having her on the board.
So Maggie Jackson just mentioning about the work of the Netball Europe board, made up of approximately 11 volunteers who work so incredibly hard to make events like this happen. If you take a look at the teams taking part, this is one of the biggest events with the most teams in. Been two invitational teams of the USA and Grenada, and a strong Challenge Cup event as well as the championship. So a lot of netball being played. The reach has been phenomenal through Twitter. The video highlights, they've been exceptional. They've been viewed by almost 41,000 netball enthusiasts, potentially new individuals seeing netball for the first time. So the live streaming, this is the second live streaming of a Netball Europe Open event, and as I've said, this is the biggest competition. So So Netball Europe, they're seeking to develop, create more opportunities, looking out for new partners, new sponsors to help drive this game forwards across the region. And remember, Netball Europe is one of the defined regions by the International Netball Federation. The board comprised of those volunteers that make events like this possible. So, final minutes of this game. Gibraltar still on the attack. Delivered safely from Rodriguez to Shari. She'll get the second chance. Taking the scoreline to 53, a massive 40 goal advantage is what Gibraltar have. So just coming forward, getting on the front of the defender, Israel. That's a better passage of play for Israel. Yes, excellent. Sturman, she got to the circle edge. Komar got on the front of the defender and safely secured that goal. Much better, Maggie.
Yeah, and that's the video clip they need to see time and time again and know how effective they can do it. No, that's a great passage of play by Israel. Gibraltar, I think, will be pleased with this last quarter, the way they've managed to attack a bit more consistently. And the shooters have managed to find that space in the circle, just that little bit more to make the feeders ease feeding that ball accurately.
So final seconds, and again disrupted by Gomez Neto. She's been a force on the wing defence, and that's the end of this challenge game. There's the scoreline, 54 goals to Gibraltar and 14 to Israel. Fine performance, some textbook netball by Gibraltar, great work in defence for both teams, but it was the structure and the solid game plan of Gibraltar that allowed them to press ahead, and that was a superb final quarter for Gibraltar. But Israel never fazed, they'll be back, they've loved their competition and this event. As you see, full of spirit and passion for this great game of netball.
It's what it's all about, isn't it? It's obviously, we're wanting our higher ranking teams, we're wanting to see that, but we're also wanting more and more countries playing netball. And Israel are a prime example of that. You see the camaraderie between Gibraltar now and Israel off the court. Great.
So all the teams, all the players, two teams together, coaches all ready, and our coverage there, you can see them all getting together, smiles all round from the Gibraltarians and the Israelis there.
Means that Israel finishes in seventh place, Gibraltar sixth place, and Malta fifth place in the overall Invitational Challenge competition.
I think we might be around for a while as we witness some of the dancing that's going on from both sides. Oh, this is fantastic. We love watching all the fun after the competition, don't we, Maggie?
Exactly, exactly. Segev, captain, really leading the way, and now we've got Komar at goal attack.
There she goes, Komar, look, she loves the limelight. She's enjoying this one, she's going out in style. Oh my goodness, there might just be a delay in the next game. Not really, they've got the time, they're enjoying themselves. Definite crowd pleaser, there they go. I'm sure for those of you back home in Israel, out there in Gibraltar, you've enjoyed those post-match celebrations of both teams. And as we said, smiles all round. That is really what this game is all about. Winning is important, but equally it is about the connections that you make with individuals around the world. And what a great event. So that concludes game one on day four. That was the challenge match between Israel and Gibraltar.
Berman having the last word and the camera. Great. Had a good game. She's really enjoyed it, hasn't she?
So we'll be closing off and back for commentary for the 11 o'clock game. That's the championship game between Northern Ireland and Scotland. Almost there, Toner, but great offload from McCleary through to Goodwin. She's the youngster, third cap for Bethan Goodwin. Outstanding performance so far through the championships.